Yeah, I'm not sure that there is a... I think we're getting closer to... We're getting better at articulating ourselves as musicians because we're just doing more of it. So you just get... It gets more refined, you know? But I don't think that the creative process is static, you know? It's a fluid thing that it's linear. It just keeps moving and evolving. So it'll just... There's no... You never arrive, you know? It's just constantly moving, so...
Yeah, and I think understanding that and not waiting for the destination, you know what I mean? Embracing the process, that's what we need, you know, or we've learned to focus on and get better at. You know, I think the songs are getting better. I think, you know, the playing's getting better. Everything's more mature. I mean, those are the natural evolutionary steps to you know, any kind of creative endeavor that you continuously hone and nurture. But yeah, I think to say this is the record, you know, it's almost like, okay, well, then we're done. You know what I mean? Then I guess we should stop. And, you know, I guess until we reach that time, we're just going to continue to let out of us what comes into us. You know, I mean, life, everything just throws you these experiences, and that can only come out in your music. And I think that has a lot to do with it, you know? Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like a good road trip. You enjoy the ride more than destination.
Of course, right. I mean, it's like you get home, but then a week later you're like, well, remember that? And remember that? And it's like, well, it wasn't about this or this. It was that cumulative thing that, you know, that we started here and we got there and, you know. I think lyrically, obviously it is. I think spiritually we've had to grow as human beings, as creative beings together. It's, you know, these abstract concepts don't seem so abstract when you live them, you know. I mean, lyrically, he's writing the lyrics, and they're very personal. What would you like to say about that?
I don't know. It's, you know, I think it's just you're constantly referencing your own experience. And so if this is how one perceives the world, it's going to come out through the art. And in some ways, I feel like the art is more accurate than these words, you know. It's a more accurate snapshot of what's really going on, because these words can only point to it. And I think music somehow captures something that is much more profound. The writing isn't a tremendous art form, but I'm saying in terms of capturing a sonic space, because to me the music goes hand in hand with the lyrics. It's all one thing. So I feel like I'm just trying to capture what's happening musically and just put a voice to it. You know, like, what does this feel like? Well, it feels like these words, I guess. But, you know, you're always just kind of touching into it. You know, you're never really able to really say it, you know. Well, I mean, there's some tremendous writers and teachers and philosophers that use this words to communicate. So I think language is very powerful, but there is an unspoken language just through sound that isn't quite as tangible. It's almost this ethereal kind of thing that has a very mysterious and beautiful quality to it that is kind of touches. I don't know. I mean, it's all good stuff, you know? It's really, it's not about one's better than the other.
Well, and I think the experience is different listener to listener, because what one person gets from it, another person gets a completely different take on it. And it can be the same emotion, but, you know, I know for me, you know, the pieces of music that move me don't necessarily move other people in that way. Like, I have these visual ideas when I hear music, or I have this... I relate it somehow to my life, and our lives are completely different. Everyone's path is different. So how you relate that song or that piece of music or that sound to your world is going to be completely specific to you and not anybody else. So
yeah, that's what's so beautiful about music, is it's so subjective. You're bringing your own stuff to it when you listen to it, and no one can have the same experience. A really sad song can lift somebody up, as to where a really happy song can make another person sad. So it's so powerful in that way. It's purely subjective.
especially in instrumental, you know, orchestral music, you know, there's no lyric guiding you to a certain idea or a certain, you know, storyline. It's about the tonal sounds. And so when he speaks about matching words to music, I think that, you know, there's something to be said. There's something around that area, and it's how he's responding to that sound. You know what I mean? It's that's his.
Yeah, because the music tells its own story without any words. You know, you're just really trying to kind of figure out how to use the 26 letters, you know, that comprises our alphabet to shape something that's close to that sound. You know, because a lot of this stuff, I think, stands without any lyrics. You know, they're pretty cool instrumental arrangements. The melody is just this other color that comes in and starts giving it another thing, but it's... Yeah, it's really a weird thing. The whole thing, I don't understand any of it, really. You know, it's...
We wanted answers. We posed more questions, Paul.
In terms of, like, with Cynic's music?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it all comes pretty naturally. I'm not sure that we sit there and think we're going to write this kind of song or think about this, tell this kind of story. It's a really kind of feeling-driven, totally raw, messy, organic process that is not calculated at all. I have no idea where it comes from, really, and it feels like we're just, you know, our bodies are being used for a process, really. I mean, it doesn't feel personal in that way. It feels really impersonal, kind of. It's just hard to explain. Yeah, it's just kind of referencing, you know, the human, what we're comprised of on a scientific level. And you know, it's funny, I had this girl interviewing me in a gig ago saying she was a biology or some major, and she's like, why'd you choose carbon as your element for your title?
That's awesome.
And I was like, well, because humans are comprised of carbon, and this is a very human record. So, you know, I thought that was really super, yeah.
Why not use a heavy metal?
Yeah.
You know, why our noble gas? Why'd you pick carbon?
Biology major had to ask.
Right, exactly. Yeah, she stares at the periodic table.
Like, carbon.
Yeah, exactly. Is there numerology? How much does it weigh? What number is it? Yeah, right.
Like,
you can
really experiment.
Right, you know.
Exactly.
I think if the right tour comes...
Well, we're touring Europe.
Yeah, we're doing Europe right after this. But then we'll be back at the end of this year. And I think the beginning of the year for us is... to get back into that unknown, crazy, creative place that we swim in sometimes, and just create more music, you know? And if an amazing tour comes along, I'm sure we'll jump on it. But I think, you know, we don't want to be absent for another year without music. And, you know, I think we're definitely in a groove, so to speak, as to where we're going with the music. And we've got a lot of material, and now it's about kind of mining these elements and arranging them again into some other piece of work, you know.